Hi guys, and welcome to my tutorial on Bantu knot out on dry hair. As you can see, I have separated a section of my hair, a pretty big piece, because I do like my Bantu knot outs to be chunkier. I am just simply detangling my hair because it has not been washed or combed in about 2 weeks. So I lightly spritzed my hair with water, and I'm now applying a fingertip amount of the Shea Moisture Curl Enhancing Smoothie, and that actually makes it a lot easier to detangle. So once you have detangled the hair enough and you've applied the Shea Moisture Smoothie to the hair, all you do is simply start twisting. Now I'm sure we're all familiar with just doing a regular two-strand twist, and that's all I'm doing here. Going all the way down to the bottom and finishing the twist. Once the twist is complete, you want to continue to twist the hair in a clockwise motion to make it tighter, to make the actual knot easier to make. Once you make the knot, you just continue to wrap your hair around and around and around your fingertips, and you continue to twist it around the knot that's being created until there is no more hair to twist around. As you guys can see, I'm just continuously going around the knot and securing the ends underneath it. Some people might actually need a pin or some type of bobbing pin to kind of hold it in, but for me, my ends, I just continue to twist and it stays relatively well for me. And the process continues here, just continuing to have a relatively medium size of hair, parted, detangled, applying Shea Moisture and twisting until my knot is formed. And when this was all said and done, you guys, I had about 20 knots in my hair. So you can have them, you can have more knots if you want, you can have less knots, depending on how you want your final look to be. The bigger the knots are, the longer it will take to dry, so also keep that in mind. And the more fluffy and less defined it will look, and the smaller your knots are, the more knots you have, it'll dry a little quicker and you will have a more defined Bantu knot out. So again, it's all about how you want your final hair to look. And this is the next day. I have let my hair dry overnight. I'm simply using an icy hair serum polisher that I like to use whether I have straight hair, curly hair. I love that stuff. You can find it at Sally's, any of your hair supply stores, but any oil that you have on hand will work just fine. Jojoba oil, argan oil, whatever, just to keep the frizz down. And right now all I'm doing is finding where I last wrapped the knot around, and I'm pulling that piece down and the hair will easily fall out of the knot. So if you have your bobbing pins in to secure it, take those out and you'll be able to let the hair fall freely. At this point, you guys, all I'm doing is separating the hair into two pieces. This is the final phase of the process. Literally separate fluff to your liking, and that's it really. As you can see here, I have separated them into smaller pieces, and I like relatively big hair, so I like it not to be super defined. I like it a little frizzy, a little puffy. That's the look I was going for. So thanks for watching, guys. I can tell the